Miss Tilly, I'm afraid I only have a few minutes.
Let's get right to it.
Hmm.
You spend a lot of time with your father.
He is a great teacher.
And your mother?
¿Qué clase de tontería es esto, María?
Es el estilo americano.
Let's talk Viviro, a cancer treatment that extends the lives of millions around the world, except in the United States. My own father is stage 4. Why do you make Americans wait?
It's very American to expect what does not belong to you.
You refuse diplomatic overtures, even promises to lift the blockade.
I am sorry about your father, but Americans will wait, just like everyone else.
Yesterday, your network, YaraVision, was hijacked by rebels. They called for the liberation of so-called outcasts from Viviro labor camps. Is Viviro produced with slave labor?
Truth or lies?
The truth, of course.
Yara did not write the playbook. Slavery was your first corporation, 1800 to 1860. Cotton was your number one export. Grown by whom?
Just a second.
Slaves. 4 million Americans worth $3.5 billion. The number one asset in your economy was people who look like me. What is that called?
A history lesson?
A head start. Replaced by a billion-dollar prison industry that pays its inmates pennies.
America is not alone.
Correct. Children sew our clothes. Sweatshops build our phones. And Viviro saves millions of lives. Do you think that those lives care where it comes from?
Santos Espinoza executed your father in the 1967 Communist Revolution. You were imprisoned at the age of 13, the same age as Diego. You were self-educated?
My mother was a wonderful teacher.
I understand you were forced to endure 15 years of hard labor, pruning tobacco. I hear you still have the blade.
When Yara becomes paradise, when I give my Viviro to America, my methods, your questions, no one will care.
We're done here?
For your father.